I want to start this video off by saying this is for people who are obsessed with the meta and play by that rather than just getting characters you love. This is for people who play the gacha solely to get cards to fill their team slots and don't care about characters as long as they have the strongest team. I think any card can work for your team if you put in the work, and this is to help you better understand the card and put it in the right team for both you and that card. If you're watching this, I'm assuming you're already well-versed in meta and gameplay, so I'm not going to explain basic gameplay stuff. If you're new and don't know mechanics yet, I have videos on that to fill in some gaps. Dorm Uniform Idia is a Defense Fire Void unit. His max HP is 15,709, which is ridiculously high. The current average HP for SSRs is 11,991, and for all cards it's 9,028. He has the 4th highest HP in EN. Clubwear Lilia is still the highest, but still. His max HP is 4,478. Predictably, this is pretty low for an SSR. But before we start jumping ship, I want to point out that this power level is basically the average max attack for SRs. For them, it's 4,400, and let's be real, a lot of us use SRs in our teams. Idia's attack may be low for an SSR, but in all honesty, his attack's actually pretty decent. He's available via a limited time rate up banner, and once that's over, he'll be added to the standard banner. So if you don't get him now, don't worry, he's not going away forever. In EN, right now, we only have 2 spells. We're getting a spell 3 in the future. So most units actually have 3 elements, but not Idia. He's still Fire Void, or Fire Void Fire if you want to be more specific. He has Flame Blast as his spell 1, he has Void Shot 2 for levels 1 through 9, and then at level 10 it turns to 0 Ray 2, and finally his spell 3 is Fire Shot 2, and that never upgrades, it just stays Fire Shot 2. Idia has a debuff removal for allies, it never changes, however at level 5 he gains a minor power drain on foes for 1 turn. Like his spell 3, it doesn't change. And speaking of spell 3, he has 2 skills attached to it. At level 1, he has blind immunity for himself for 1 turn. At level 5, that skill transfers to allies, and it stays that way. But at level 10, he gains a minor damage cut to foes for 1 turn. So yeah, Idia has a total of 4 skills, which is honestly freaking insane. Unsurprisingly, Idia's duo magic partner is Ortho, who also gives him a minor HP boost. His other buddies are Azula and Jack. They also give him a minor HP boost because 15,000 wasn't enough, I guess. Oh well, I'll take the extra numbers, you know. Now, this will come at a later date. It's JP only right now. But eventually, when you get Idia's first limit break, you'll earn 2 special furniture items. You'll be able to make and hang pictures of his card art in your guest room. So, I didn't realize this until I was searching my spreadsheet, but Idia's the only unit with debuff removal. I could have sworn we had others, but I checked not just my NEN section of my spreadsheet, but my JP only section as well, and there was nothing. Usually, I like recommending units with the same skill, but I literally cannot do that in this case. So we're just gonna have to go off the rails here and mostly look at spells and stats and the other skills. It was also hard to find only Fire Void units when taking into account spell 3, so like, we did our rubestie with these alternatives, but I'm going to preface this by saying there's absolutely no one-to-one to Dorm Idia. At least, not right now in EN or JP. The best alternatives I could find are Clubwear Kaleem, Birthday Boy Floyd, Labwear Silver, and PE Rook. Kaleem has a lower HP but a higher attack than Idia. He has Fire Shot 2, but it's his spell 3, so right now they have no spells in common. However, Kaleem has both Blind Immunity and Power Drain on foes, and his spell 3 also has a damage cut to foes. 3 out of 4 of the same skills is honestly pretty good, even if you'll have to wait for that spell 3 and damage cut. They share no buddies, but fun fact, Idia is one of Kaleem's buddies. Floyd also has a lower HP but higher attack than Idia. His spells are more similar with having Zero Ray and Fire Shot 2, later Flame Blast 2. His spell 3 is Leash Shot, so oofies. I'll say his spell similarity is where Floyd shines the best, although he does have damage cut to foes. The good news is that his actually upgrades, so it's better than Idia's. The downside is that it's attached to his spell 3. And he and Idia have no buddies in common. Labwear Silver obviously has lower stats all around, but his HP is 11,769, which, while it's not super close to Idia, it's actually pretty good. Silver's best qualities in this scenario besides HP are his spells. He has Flame Blast and Void Shot too. And if Idia's skills and HP are the most attractive thing to you, this is why I would suggest Silver as an alternative. Silver's sole skill is damage resistance to caster, and his 2 buddies are not shared with Idia, so spells and HP are really the draw here. And finally, PE Rook. To be honest, this is kind of the same situation with Silver. My suggestion of Rook comes from him being a defense card and his spells. He has Void Shot, later Zero Ray, and Fire Shot 2. He has no skills and his buddy is Apple. I love Rook. I've made the joke that I'm a Rook apologist often. But yeah, he just doesn't have a lot going for him in this case. Idia is going to be a very versatile unit, and I don't think you're going to have to work hard to put him into any team. That debuff removal is helpful to any team. But if we want to get specific, I think once that Spell 3 update comes, he'll be indispensable in mono fire teams. I mean, I think even now if you wanted to put him on that kind of team, he'd still be insanely helpful. In my opinion though, Idia can just go anywhere he needs to be. He might have rare skills, but they aren't so specific that he needs to be put into a niche team. You can shove him into almost any team and he'll be great in it. If you try for Idia, I hope you get him early. And if you don't get him now, don't worry, he's still going to be around. And that's going to be it for me today. I wish you all luck, and I'll see y'all later. Bye! Once again, thank you everyone for watching my videos. If you would like to support me beyond liking and subscribing and all of that, I have a Patreon and I also have channel memberships. If you like live streaming, I live stream over on Twitch every Tuesday, Thursday, and Sunday. But yeah, thank you guys for watching my videos, and I hope they help you. And yeah, bye! Shameless plug over.